Tulane is and always has been a national leader in interdisciplinary research. At our founding, we were focused on how to solve issues of cholera and yellow fever, and that brought together doctors and public health and experts from different fields. That created a culture here, an energy, a focus on bringing together learning from different areas. The Brain Institute is a shining example of that approach. The brain combines all the different parts of the human system to understand it, to improve its functionings, to really make a difference. You need to bring together faculty from across the university.
Understanding the brain is a true frontier in biomedical research. We recognize how little we understand about how the brain works normally to encode memory, cognition, emotion, and how those functions are disrupted in the disease states we've sadly come to know so well, like Alzheimer's and stroke.
Neurologic diseases are very important presently because there's an increasing number of neurologic diseases, particularly as the population ages, a number of entities that are growing in frequency, like traumatic brain injury. And also, science has advanced remarkably in neurologic both diseases and understanding of the nervous system and the brain. So it's an appropriate time that the entire body of scientists and physicians focus on neurologic diseases.
There is momentum across the country right now to better understand the brain and brain disease. I think the Tulane Brain Institute is in an excellent position to be a major contributor to that understanding. We are bringing together under one entity faculty from a school of medicine, a school of science and engineering, and a primate center to work together to answer some of the biggest questions in neuroscience.
Well, it was a coming together of a number of things. It was the critical mass that neuroscience already had, and the idea that Nick and Lee Ham and Jill and Laura Levy all wanted to put this institute together, take advantage of the School of Science and Engineering, take advantage of School of Medicine, the Primate Center, Public Health, Liberal Arts, and take all the strengths of that and put it together in this initiative and cross silos. Add to that, you know, Mike Fitz wants Tulane to do a lot of interdisciplinary work, and it fits that marvelously, and maybe this is even a role model for, you know, what the school can accomplish when people cross silos and work together.
The vision of the Brain Institute is to approach these otherwise intractable problems by bringing together scholars with complementary expertise across a broad range of disciplines. So, for example, the Brain Institute will facilitate collaboration between a biologist who works at the lab bench or with animal models and a computer scientist who can integrate the new knowledge from the lab bench into models that can allow them to make testable predictions, or with a biomedical engineer who can integrate the knowledge from the lab bench into workable, real solutions that affect people's lives.
So the immediate goal is to give the Brain Institute a real presence on our campus, a real identity on our campus. We want to put a facility in Flower Hall. In fact, that's all that we're going to start on that very soon. So there will be a central office and core facility in Flower Hall, and that will be at the center of one of the core areas of the Brain Institute, which is memory and cognition. Also, we'd like to build a similar facility downtown. It would be a core facility and office, which would also be affiliated with the Brain Institute, that would focus on one of their other core areas, which is neurodegenerative disease. I anticipate that would be in the J. Bennett Johnston building. So that would be the first goal, would be to get the Brain Institute that location, that identity, and elevate those two core areas. Not only in the area of research, but also in the area of teaching and outreach.
Well, I look forward in years to come to this center really being a leader nationally for generations in how to understand and improve the functioning of the brain.